Hello YouTubers, in this video I will try to prove that reality are made of numbers from perspective of mathematics and later transition to physics and physical world. Mathematics and physics deals with two concepts, discrete and continuous. Discrete means integer, non-divisional number of one single object. Continuous means as one bulk object. Mass, volume, example, water in container. We don't care about single atom who are discrete. We describe water by his mass, volume, or density in occupied space. We can make conclusion that discrete is more important than something continuous. That is also not fully correct. Example, the time. We know that time arrow is continuous, but for calculation purposes we use discrete time measurement unit, second, minute, hour, millisecond, but that is just convenience. In practice we know that the time is continuous and time measurement can be any non-discrete time period. Better explanation that both concepts are important and reality made of both of discrete and continuous. We have transcendental mathematical constants P and E. One of the features of this transcendental constant is that these constants are irrational and cannot be written as proportion of discrete and natural integer numbers. They can be only very close approximation, and these math constants together with trigonometric function of sine, cosine and natural logarithm makes transcendental functions. These three functions are building block of reality. In my video Light Wave is Mathematics, I argued that electromagnetic wave light is written in terms of mathematics language as transcendental math constant E and pi. I tried to explain light behavior, why light goes shorter path or goes shorter time path, so-called Fermat principle. Math, or more precisely algebra, calculus and geometry tools gives answer how to calculate Fermat principle of light diffraction through transparent media, why predetermined condition that light will behave in such way, but only math constant gives answer why light behave in such way. An answer is that light beam or light particle made from or building block of light are math constants in form of transcendental function of sine, cosine and natural logarithm. And transcendental math constant always keeps least path or least time rule for light behavior. Light is not very intuitive concept. Light is very small, so better example is big things or macro objects. Example is classical mechanics and flight trajectory of projectile in the Earth gravity field. Here is projectile being projected from cannon barrel with initial velocity V0 and initial angle theta 0. After some time projectile will reach height h, and this height equation is such. I'm not questioning is this equation good, in my opinion, but it is. On the other hand, trajectory of projectile of parabola is questionable. My emphasis is not how this equation been derived. Yes, it was used mathematical tools of calculus to physics, second Newton law of motion, geometry angles, algebra rules, trigonometric relation, and maybe more mathematics and physics rules. My point is how projectile, let's say we know that the projectile is in an inanimate object without consciousness, how it knows to read height h and not violate energy conservation law? Answer lies in initial angle theta 0 and in sine function. Fundamental basis of science, not just physics, is energy and mass conservation law. Nothing can be created from nothing. The nature or the God, depending on belief system, must use some material to create reality. And this material is trigonometric and exponential transcendental function. All information about energy conservation law is coded in this function, and in our case in sine function of ballistic projectile flight trajectory. Projectile is inanimate object, but it knows where a height h for reason not to violate energy conservation law. Holy Trinity is that energy, mass, information, all they must sustain quantity and conservation law. Both all these functions are made from continuous and discrete numbers. We are expand the sine function via Taylor-Maclaurin math series. First, we have continuous irrational number inside sine function as transcendental math constant pi. Second, we have discrete integer numbers in form of n from 0 to 2, 3, and etc., which goes to infinity. That is called countable infinity, where p and e math constants are never-ending irrational numbers. So infinity energy is possible just by this fact. Also, factorial is always discrete number. So we have both concepts in one function, and I wanted to prove that this function knows height h without violating energy conservation. It is very important because sine function is spectrum is constrained by 0 and 1, and as we know, energy absolute value is between 1. Also, special case when projectile projected perpendicular to the ground or objects fallen perpendicular to the ground. We have case sine p divided by 2 equals to 1. In equations, sine p divided by 2 equal not show. It's a trivial multiplication by unit 1 to make equation more compact and neat to read. But same as exponential raised by 0 equals to 1 is always present in equation. All nature is based on waves. This theory that contemporary matter is made of waves also present in physics. Example, string theory, where every elementary particle have different frequency closed-loop vibration waves. Schrödinger wave equation, where elementary particle represented as waves. Wave particle duality also applicable to electrons and atoms. My belief are in holographical principle, where a 3D space and matter represented as Fourier math series in 2D plane. Taylor-Maclaurin sine, cosine and exponential function is not the same as Fourier series. We have similar connection, whereas Fourier series is more generalized case of Taylor-Maclaurin math series. Only they both goes to infinity. This time we will use exponential transcendental function e raised by x to show that this sequence goes to infinity, and to show difference between pure mathematics and theoretical physics and engineering. It is not the same. Engineering based on value approximation, pure mathematics and theoretical physics interested in more abstract theoretical and symbolical values. Example, Planck law of black body radiation intensity from frequency f from 1 square meter area surface with constant initial temperature T. This shows distribution of various energy range of electromagnetic waves. In engineering, infinity not important, but it is present anyway. One of the evidence is ultraviolet catastrophe, also called the Rayleigh-Jeans catastrophe, was the prediction of a 19th century, early 20th century classical physics that an ideal black body at thermal equilibrium will emit radiation in all frequency ranges, emitting more energy as the frequency increases. Rayleigh-Jeans equation can be derived from Planck equation for very short range of frequency. Let x and frequency is very small. From Planck equation we get Rayleigh-Jeans equation. Planck law is generalized. We get approximation. We ignore small values because when value is small to calculate infinity, it's not necessary. That is different between pure math and theoretical physics and engineering and philosophy. Does matter one droplet of water in the ocean? We know answer that no, but everyone knows that ocean made from infinity small droplets of water. Engineering don't care about accuracy, they only care about rough estimation. That is also not direct proof that perpetual engine, free energy machine, is impossible. To catch every small energy value in infinite math series technically possible, but practical not achievable, just because n discrete numbers goes to infinity. And infinity is not the number. Zero is the number value. Infinity is undefined value, same as transcendental math constant pi and e. Their values after commas goes to infinity. The nature or God chopped reality into infinity small pieces. That is very hard to understand. Sine, cosine, exponential function are used in engineering calculation every day without thinking what stands behind this function. And this function on which our reality is based on. That is all, folks. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.